Sally here, and I thought I'd start with a song for a change. And that is a very simple children's song called Old Mister Woodpecker. Now, you could hear the woodpecker, couldn't you, doing some tapping in the background. And this is a great example of how a song that you can use in piano classes that gets the musical ear engaged. It's a lot of fun, and eventually you can take it onto the piano if you like as well. Now, where I live, I'm very, very lucky because I've got a beautiful wood not just 5 minutes away, and I was there on Sunday having a walk, and there I heard the woodpecker tapping away. And we quite often this time of year as well get the woodpeckers coming into our neighbour's garden who's got a bird feeder, and there's this big green spotted woodpecker hanging there. And when I'm doing a song like this, I love to just bring it to life. Tell the children the story. Have they seen a woodpecker? Do they get one on their grass? Of course, it depends where you live, whether you get one or not. If they don't know what a woodpecker looks like, you might show them it, and you might actually show them the very long beak that a woodpecker has and say, I wonder why it's called a woodpecker, and you know, talk about that whole thing. But we can do this sort of musicianship activity in online lessons. I'm doing this every single time I teach at the moment. I'm doing a lot of musicianship because it works a treat. Let me show you how. So the first thing I'll do is I will sing the song all the way through like I've just done, and I'll probably tell a bit of the story. And then I would say, now listen to my song again. And I wonder how many times you can count the word woodpecker. Yeah? How many times do you count it? And I'll sing it again like this. Off I go, old Mr. Woodpecker sitting in a tree. Old Mr. Woodpecker sing tapping merrily. Now, sometimes I forgot to tap. I was so excited by the whole thing. And so hopefully they would count. Yep, I heard two there. Sally, yeah, absolutely. What do you think, I might say? What do you think my sticks are pretending to be? Because did you notice I sang and then I tapped and then I sang and then I tapped? I'm pretending to be the woodpecker, aren't I? So before you can pretend to be the woodpecker with my sticks, I'm going to teach you the song. So I can see lots of you are out there. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for popping in and listening. Do stay around because I've got a free PDF, which will be appearing down below here. But my turn, your turn. This is what I would do with the children. Listen to me and then it's your turn. Nice, clear gestures make such a difference. Then I sing to them. Off I go, old Mr. Woodpecker sitting in a tree. Over to them. My turn, old Mr. Woodpecker sit tapping merrily. I hope you're all doing it out there and I'm not just singing to myself. Anyhow, that's the thing to do, is the gestures have got to be really, really clear, and the child will often join in, yeah? If they don't, you notice that I'm just singing along it anyhow. So don't worry too much if they don't immediately join in. You know, some of them are shyer than others, but it's just a question of just capturing their attention a little bit. You'll find that they will join in eventually. You don't need to make a big thing about it though. So then I would say, okay, now I wonder, let's sing the song from the beginning. Only this time, can we tap the rhythm pattern of the words in our fingers? Old Mr. Woodpecker sitting in a tree. Could you do that? And at this point, lots of modelling, lots of support for them, not leaving them by themselves that other side. And if mum and dad are around, then get them doing it, or everybody's doing it together. And then hopefully somewhere they might have something that they could use to do the tapping. Now, I've got my claves. They could otherwise tap on the top of the piano lid, or they could get some spoons from the kitchen. What fun. Go off and explore the house and see what you can find. And of course, you could go all around the house and find all sorts of different things. That could be one of the activities they do. And then you'd come to the point where you're going to sing it all the way through. So to start off, going to have our sticks or whatever we're using ready, and I would sing, Are you ready? Off we go. Old Mister Woodpecker sitting in a tree, tapping. Old Mister Woodpecker tapping merrily. Now, the very first lesson you do that, and that's probably all that you would do, you probably wouldn't take it any further because that's quite enough concentration for one time. You would be there with your students supporting them, and as I say, you wouldn't go any further. But the next lesson, you might then get them to sing it back to you, see if they remember it, have they got something to tap with? Oh, very good. And then you might take it further and do some work on rhythm. So what we've got here is that the rhythm pattern of the words. Beautiful phrase, gets children really understanding rhythm. Old Mr. Woodpecker sitting in a tree. Have a listen. Now with all my pupils, they use rhythm language at this early age. Counting is too complex for them to get there. Little heads round, so we use rhythm language such as ta and titi. So that would translate as, and again I would model it to them, off I go, ta, titi, ta, titi, 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 ta, and get them to copy, ta, titi, ta, and say it, titi, 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 ta. It's always hard, and rest as well, mustn't forget the rest. It's always hard to get them to say the rhythm language. It's so important that whether you're an adult, you're a child, you count out loud, you say rhythm out loud. Yeah, absolutely essential for us to really, really learn about that rhythm. And that can then lead into some lovely rhythm games. So it could be my turn, off I go. And they have to clap that one. And then I would say, sorry, ta, ta, ti, ti, ta, and they clap it back. Okay, now this time, could you say the rhythm language? Have a listen. Off I go. And this time they tap it with the rhythm language as well. All sorts of wonderful little things that you can do with that song. And to help you with that song, there is a pupils worksheet, a student worksheet that you can download. I'll put it in the comments, but there's also a teacher's guide. And you'll discover that that song, it's very simple, but you can work on rhythm. You can work on the thinking voice, so important, the thinking voice. And you can introduce concepts such as that crotchet rest or that quarter note rest, whatever it is you want to call it. So there's lots of ideas in the activities for teachers, the teacher's guide, and you can give this download and give your student the Old Mr. Woodpecker song sheet. I hope that's been helpful. I'm going to be using that this afternoon in my teaching. I do hope you're all keeping safe. Keep well. Enjoy. Bye-bye.